What if we told you that the simple act of raising your arm could challenge the foundations of our understanding of reality? Intriguing, isn't it? Imagine this scenario. A speaker in a room full of students and professors at the University of Miami, preparing to deliver his talk, claims he will perform a miracle to kickstart the discussion. He takes a moment, composes himself, and then, with dramatic flair, raises his arm. Then he raises his other arm. What might initially seem like an underwhelming display, he presents as a miraculous feat. But why? Why would something as mundane as lifting one's arm be considered miraculous? Well, to understand this, he invites the audience to provide a purely naturalistic, scientific explanation for his arm's movement. A professor rises to the challenge, delivering an impressive rundown of the electrochemical reactions that enable such a movement. However, the speaker points out a significant omission. What initiated these electrochemical reactions? What was the spark that set off this cascade of events? After a pause, a woman from the audience rises and says, "You did it." And the speaker replies, "That's exactly right, I did it." And therein lies the crux of the issue. The speaker, it seems, is not merely his body. He is an entity associated with his body, capable of controlling it. This simple fact challenges the atheistic naturalist worldview, which struggles to provide a satisfactory explanation for this act of will. Atheistic naturalism presupposes that everything, including you and all your actions, can be reduced to the laws of physics. But is there a law of physics dictating when one should raise their arm? Certainly not. The act of raising your arm, a decision you make, is not something that can be predetermined or explained solely by physical laws. As Paul Nelson explains, methodological naturalism entails an ontology in which minds are the consequence of physics, and thus, can only be placeholders for a more detailed causal account in which physics is the only, ultimate actor. You didn't write your email to me. Physics did, and informed you of that event after the fact. Yet, to explain the effects you bring about in the world, we must refer to you as a unique agent. Moreover, emerging evidence from quantum mechanics strongly indicates that humans aren't reducible to the laws of physics, as is presupposed within atheistic naturalism. As the late atheist physicist Steven Weinberg noted, quantum mechanics introduces a level of choice into the laws of nature, a far cry from the deterministic worldview postulated by classical physics. Specifically, Weinberg stated, "In the instrumentalist approach, in quantum mechanics, humans are brought into the laws of nature at the most fundamental level. The instrumentalist approach turns its back on a vision that became possible after Darwin, of a world governed by impersonal physical laws that control human behavior along with everything else. In quantum mechanics, these probabilities do not exist until people choose what to measure. Unlike the case of classical physics, a choice must be made." Moreover, Anton Zeilinger, a recent Nobel laureate who closed the freedom of choice loophole in quantum mechanics, further emphasizes this point. He stated, "What we perceive as reality now depends on our earlier decision what to measure, which is a very, very deep message about the nature of reality and our part in the whole universe. We are not just passive observers. To repeat, we aren't just passive observers in the universe. We are active participants, our choices shaping the very fabric of reality. Thus, directly contrary to the presuppositions of atheistic naturalism and via advances in quantum mechanics, humans are now experimentally shown to not be reducible to the laws of physics. Rather, humans are brought into the laws of nature at the most fundamental level." In summary, the act of raising one's arm, seemingly simple and mundane, reveals a profound truth about our existence. It challenges the atheistic naturalism's ability to fully explain our actions and our role in the universe, suggesting that we are more than just physical entities bound by the laws of physics. We are entities with the power of will, capable of participating in and shaping our reality.